I want to name some prominent people who have been involved with America's racial history, and I'd like you to tell me simply if they were Republicans or if they were Democrats.
Okay.
Let's begin with the inventor of the positive good school of slavery, the idea that slavery was a good idea, Senator John C. Calhoun.
Democrat.
What about the guy who invented popular sovereignty, the idea that each territory could decide for itself if it wanted slavery, yes or no, Stephen Douglas?
Democrat.
What about the writer of the Dred Scott decision authorizing slavery and claiming that blacks have no rights that a white man ought to respect, Roger Taney?
That sounds like a Democrat.
What about the founder of the Ku Klux Klan, Nathan Bedford Forrest, who was also a Confederate general?
Democrat.
What about the great champions of segregation, the people who legislated separate but equal and the black codes throughout the South?
Democrat.
What about Bull Connor, the famous or infamous sheriff who resisted the civil rights movement?
Democrat.
What about the Arkansas governor, Orville Faubus, who shut the doors of the Arkansas schoolhouse until federal troops had to come in to allow black students to get in the door?
Democrat.
What about George Wallace, who said, segregation now, segregation forever?
Democrat. They're all Democrats.
Let's now talk about a few more figures in American history who resisted racial oppression. Abraham Lincoln.
Republican.
His Secretary of State, Seward.
Republican.
What about the two leading senators who championed the cause of abolitionism, Thaddeus Stevens and Sumner?
Well, they were Republicans.
What about Frederick Douglass, the runaway slave who became a champion of the abolitionist movement?
Republican.
What about Booker T. Washington, born a slave and champion of the idea of self-help?
Republican.
What about Eisenhower, who desegregated the armed forces and sent federal troops to allow blacks to enter the Arkansas schoolhouse?
Republican.